Namaskar student, today we will going to learn few topics from moving charges and magnetism. So this is my first topic, motion in a magnetic field. So when a charge in a magnetic field, the magnetic force is perpendicular to the velocity of a particle. So here the net work done is zero, so there is no work done and no charge in the magnitude of velocity is produced. So there will be no charge. Now let me consider the motion. Here the electric field is QE, where Q is the charge. And now we consider the motion of a charge particle in a uniform magnetic field. So first of all, V is always perpendicular to B. So what is the perpendicular force? QV into B. So it acts as a centripetal force and produces a circular motion which is perpendicular to the magnetic field. So here V and B are always perpendicular to each other. If the velocity has components along B, these components remains unchanged. So the motion of a magnetic field will not be affected by the magnetic field which is present. So here the plane perpendicular to B, this one is perpendicular to B, just like the same as before, as circular one. So this is producing a motion which is called helical motion. This is helical motion. This one is called helical motion. So if here R is the radius of the circular path, then the force, we know that what is the value of force, mv square by R. So we can, it acts perpendicular to the path towards the center of the circle. Here if the velocity B and B is the magnetic field, the magnetic force is perpendicular to then V and B, these are the perpendicular force. So here it always act like a centripetal force. It has a magnitude. So what is the magnitude? Q, V and B. So equating the equation, these two are equal. So mv square by R equals to QVB. So here R is the radius, which is denoted as mv by QB. So the larger of momentum, the larger of the radius and the bigger the charge described. So here here we can say that, so here omega is an angular frequency. So if this one is the angular frequency, then we can write V equivalent to omega R. So we can put the value, so we will get omega equals to 2 pi V, it is equivalent to QB by M. This is equivalent, so it is independent of the velocity or energy. This one is independent. So here V is the frequency of rotation, and which is independent from energy, has this is independent, and this applicable for the design of cyclotron. Now let me take t is the time for one revolution. We can write t equivalent to capital T equivalent to 2 pi by omega, or we can write 1 by v. If there is a component of a velocity which is parallel to the magnetic field, then we can write the particle moves along the field, and the path of a particle is always like helical one. So here we say that the distance move along the magnetic field in one rotation, it is called a pitch. So here P is a pitch, which is denoted as 2 pi m v by q into b. So this is pitch. At the radius of a circular component, this is the radius of a circular component of motion is called the radius of helix. This is all about radius of helix and helical motion. My next topic is motion of charged particle in a electric and magnetic field. So here this is the we know that electric force can be defined as F equals to Q into E. So we also know that F equals to MA. So here F equals to A equals to F by M. So we can put the value which is QE by M. What is the magnetic force? This is all about electric force. Now what is magnetic force? FB, which is Q V into B. Now what is the total force? Which is called total force is called Lorentz force, magnetic force plus electric force. So which is equivalent to QE plus QV into B. So this is the graph which is represented. Now we can say that here Q is the charge. Here Q is the charge with velocity V, which presence of both electric and magnetic field. Now which is expressed as F equals to QE plus QV into B, electric force and magnetic force. Now let us consider these two are electric and magnetic force. Now we can write this is also perpendicular with the velocity. So here E equals to EJ, because this for this J is the vector, for Y J is the vector, and here B equals to BK, for Z axis K is the vector, and for V equals to VI, for X axis I is the vector. So after putting all this value, we can get Q equals to V into B, V into B, where FE. So we can say that equivalent to QVI into BK. Here these two are direction is the direction is the y axis, so minus Q BJ. Therefore F is equals to Q E minus VB into J. So this one is the electric and magnetic force are in opposite direction as this is given in the figure. So if we adjust the value of E and B, so the magnitude of the two forces are equal. So here the total force of the charge becomes zero. So we can write QE equals to QVB here. V equals to what? E by B. So the condition can be used as a select charge particle of a particular velocity out of the beam containing charge moving with different speed for this condition. So this is all about motion in a combined electric and magnetic field. My next topic is cyclotron. So cyclotron is a machine. Okay, it accelerated a particle or ion of high energies to high energies. So the cyclotron used both electric and magnetic field. The combination of the increases the energy charge particle. As the fields are perpendicular to each other, it is called cross field. These two fields are perpendicular to each other. Here cyclotron used impact of the frequency revolution and charge particle in a magnetic field is independent with the energy. So here two discs are there, one is D1 and another is D2. Two semicircular discs, one is D1 and another D2. These are called Ds, and they look like these are called Ds because they look like D letter. So inside this metal box, these are the shielded. Is not acted on by the electric field, and the magnetic field, however acts on a particle to make it to round in a circular path. So like this, okay, the sign of an electric field is change alternatively in the tune and the circular motion and the particle so this one is always in circular motion, so it always accelerated by the electric field. So for each time the acceleration increases with the energy of a particle. If the energy increased, then the circular path also increased. Like this is a circular path increase. So the path is a spiral path. So here we can say that a higher frequency alternative voltage is applied, very high frequency alternative, this one applied to the Ds, and the positive ion is positively charged particles which is released at the center at P. They move in a semicircular path in one of these and arrive the gap between them, and this D, the time interval is T/2. Then we can write that this is a period of revolution. So T equals to 1/Vc, which is equivalent to 2 pi m into Q by Q B. So here, what is the value of VC? VC equals to QB by 2 pi m. So this is the cyclotron frequency. This frequency is called cyclotron. VC is called cyclotron frequency, where VA is the voltage applied, means applied voltage of a polarity of the D's. Okay, now the same time it takes that the ion complete 1/2 of revolution. So here, if we say that VA equals to VC, which is called resonance condition, the VA means velocity applied voltage, and the and this one VC, these two are equal, then we can say that the phase of supply adjusts so that the positive ions arrive D1 to D2 is the lower potential. So here this one is accelerated across the gap, for this gap. So inside the D's, particle travel in a region of free of a electric field, and the increase of their kinetic energy, which is equivalent to Q each time they cross from the D's, they cross from one D's and it is and comes from another D's. And now the path goes on increasing each time with their kinetic energy increases. So the ions rapidly accelerated across the D until they have required the energy to have a radius. So it increases till that the energy. So here then the deflected by the magnetic field of a system can be written as V equals to QBR by M, where R is the radius of the trajectory of exist, or this one is or this is equal to the radius of D. So hence we can write this is equivalent to kinetic energy. So 1/2 2mv². So we have to put the value of V. So here q² v² r² / 2m. So this is the operation of the cyclotron based in the fact of a time of one revolution of an ion is independent of its speed or radius of its orbit. So this is all about cyclotron. So this cyclotron is used in bombard nuclei with electrical with energetic particle, or that because it accelerated by it. So this one resulting the nuclear reaction, and here it is also used in for an ions into solid and modify their properties and even synthesize new material. It is used in hospital to produce radioactive substance and used in diagnostic and for the treatment. These are the uses of cyclotron. So this is all about cyclotron. This is a very, very important topic. This is all about cyclotron and motion in a combined electric and magnetic field, and this one motion in a magnetic field. So thank you, student, for watching this video.